Welcome back, everyone. In this segment, I'm going to show you how to actually install Anaconda on a macOS system. So the first thing to do is actually to start up your Safari and type anaconda.com. Okay, so let's just wait for the software to open up. Okay, now that this is up and running, what we need to do next is to actually observe this, and there are a couple of things that's really useful with this. You can of course look at what is Anaconda and read through and understand that a little bit more. Okay, you can of course download some of the white papers. One of the beauty of Anaconda, which I really enjoy and like, is the fact that it has a lot of I guess you could call it built-in libraries. If you look at this, you can actually see that there are Jupyter notebook available. Let me just zoom in. You can see that Spyder is available. There's Jupyter notebook available. There's RStudios, Jupyter Lab. You also have NumPy, SciPy, and all the relevant so-called Panda libraries, or rather data science libraries, that's useful for the, you know, to perform your role as a data scientist. There are also visualizers available, such as Bokeh, Matplotlib, that we will use a lot, and of course machine learning, such as TensorFlow and scikit-learn, that we will use quite a fair bit in this lesson. There are other things that's really useful. I already mentioned a lot of these. You can also make use of the Condor package. Why do we actually make use of Condor? The reason is quite straightforward. It's really a package manager. It brings together all the dependencies, all the libraries together, so that they don't actually conflict with each other. Now, if you are familiar with the GUI interface, such as Windows, such as MacBook, or should I say macOS, you will enjoy this interface much more. You have the Anaconda Navigator that allows you to very quickly launch either Jupyter Notebook, the Qt console, or Spyder, and on it goes. Right, so let's just close this and get on with the actual download. You can actually download from products, selecting this, or you can actually select download. Okay, I'm going to just make use of this. So I'll wait for that to download. Okay, and I'm going to make use of the Mac OS, and I'm going to download the Python 3.6 version. Okay, so if you want to get an older version, read this instruction and also teach you how to install Anaconda as well. So for now, we just need to make use and download the Python 3.6 version and just select that. Okay, so you have the cheat sheet. Feel free to actually enter your email and get the starter guide. I already downloaded mine, so I'm not going to be concerned with that. So I'm going to select no thanks, but I will encourage you to actually download for yourself, because it's highly useful. It will get you started on that very quickly. What else do I want to actually go through with you while this is actually downloading at the background here? You have the documentation that you can read. There are also talks about what are the packages that's included in Anaconda, and it also teach you, show you how to learn Python as well. So you might want to actually play around with that and also try out Conda itself. One of the beauty of Anaconda is that it's a BSD licensed. Now, what does that mean? It gives you the permission to use Anaconda commercially and for redistribution as well. They do have webinars available, so you can actually go there and let's have a look. Okay, it talks about big data and data science. It talks about unveiling Anaconda Enterprise 5, which is actually quite exciting. So there's quite a lot of there are quite a lot of contents available for you to actually search through. Okay, so let's go back. Well, we'll wait for the download. All right, the download has been completed. So let's just select this and run this. Okay, so here it actually walks you through how to actually install this. We just follow the instructions, continue, read the EULA, okay, and continue. Again, this is EULA. Wait, what is that? This is, that was EULA. This is the Okay, so it tells you a little bit about where this is will be installed. Okay, so let's just, so this is installed for me only, so no admin. So continue. Yep, so customize this. Okay, that's fine. Install. Okay, so wait for the installation to complete then. Okay, now that it's finished installing, so we're gonna close that. Do you want to remove? Yes, we don't need that anymore. Okay, now that's fine, it's done now. Now what we want to do now is to actually launch this. Now the question is, how do you launch this? So go to your launch pad. Okay, you see the Anaconda Navigator, so that's pretty much what you use to launch the Anaconda. So double click on that. Okay, yep, that's fine. Now what you can see here is that there's a few ways to launch the programs that we want to use. One is use this to launch notebook, so you just click that and it will actually launch the notebook. All right, in your clear this, it will launch this here in your folder itself. Now notice that it has actually launched this in Safari. Okay, so in order to run a Python, you just select Python 3 and you call this test run. Okay, and change this to that. Okay, this is our first trial. Okay, so you can import NumPy, for example, as np. Okay, so that's not correct. Right, so it's installed that correctly for us. Okay, so Jupyter Notebook is running fine now. So let's go back to, let's just minimize that. Come back to our Anaconda Navigator. To run the spider, again, you just select launch. And it will launch the spider for you. Do you want to accept? Yes, allow that. What we have here really is, you can actually do likewise. You can also import NumPy as np just to test it. Okay, it runs fine without any problem at all. So if I type np.random, okay, it provides the different options that I wanted. So ran, so let's just give me 5 random number, and there we go, we have the 5 random numbers. Okay, those are all working really well. What we do want to do now is to create an environment, a virtual environment, to protect our development environment so that it doesn't interfere with our existing projects, and also we want to create a sandbox to protect this project. Now how do you do that? So you come to environment here, you actually create an environment. So let's just call this Iris project. We're going to select Python 3.6. okay, and notice where it's actually being stored to or created. The location is users Anthony / Anaconda 3 / environments / Iris _ project, which is the name of this project. So you just click create. It shouldn't take long for this to create. Once it's done, then the next thing that we do is that we start creating the so-called libraries, or adding the libraries that we want. So let's just wait for that to finish creating. So it's creating the environment right now, so we'll just wait for that. Okay, the installations or the creation of the environment is complete. We have Python here that we can use. What is missing now is the basic Anaconda package that we need. So let's just look for Anaconda. So we need that. So let's just apply that and install that. Again, this might take a while. I'll just accelerate the video. Okay, finally the installation is now completed. Now in order for us to run our Iris project in this environment, there are two ways that you can actually run this. You can open the Jupyter Notebook via this. If you want to run it from the root, select the root first, and then out of the right arrow, choose what you actually want to do. Under the Iris projects, we'll just select Iris project. Let's run the Jupyter Notebook. So basically you just open with Jupyter Notebook, And there you have it. Now what you have now is that it is running within the Iris environment. Okay, so let's just minimize this. Okay, the alternative is if you want to run spider, for example, then you actually have to open up the terminal and just type spy spyder. Okay, that will run. What you will notice that at the background here, let me just allow that. In the background here, it has this bracket here. It's telling you where your which environment has been activated. So within here, so what we really just need to do is again just test that everything is working fine. Import pandas. Yep, that runs just fine. Pandas.read. Okay, so it actually has all the basic relevant stuff that we need. So let's just close that off. So that's pretty much all that I really want to show you. Yep, terminate this. In terms of running, first of all, create the virtual environment and then installing the relevant dependencies that you want, and finally running your packages, okay, be it Jupyter Notebook or run it spider. Now you do notice that you can actually clone this environment and you know clone it to a separate project. So with that, I'm going to end this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you found it useful. Thank you so much for paying attention.